First of all, of course, begin by wishing you all a happy new year. I guess it's still time to do that, given that we are just exactly halfway through between our Western New Year and the Lunar New Year, which will loom in a few weeks' time. I think it's also appropriate to wish ourselves a happy new year, given what I would like to talk to you about, which has to do with the global economy and what we should expect for 2014. Now, I'm going to test you numerology skills by asking you to think about the magic seven. Okay? Most of you will know that seven is quite a number in all sorts of themes, religions, and I'm sure that you can compress numbers as well. If we think about 2014, all right, I'm just giving you 2014, you drop the zero, 14, two times seven. Okay, that's just by way of example, and we're going to carry on. So 2014 will be a milestone and hopefully a magic year in many respects. It will mark the 100th anniversary of the First World War back in 1914. It will mark the 70th anniversary, of the Bretton Woods Conference that actually gave birth to the IMF. And it will be the 25th anniversary of the fall of the Berlin Wall. 25th. Also mark the 7th anniversary of the financial market jitters that quickly turned into the greatest global economic calamity since the Great Depression. The crisis still lingers. Yet, optimism is in the air. We've left the deep freeze behind us, and the horizon looks just a bit brighter. So my hope and my wish for 2014 is that after those seven miserable years, weak and fragile, we have seven strong. Now, I don't know whether the G7 will have anything to do with it or whether it will be the G20. I certainly hope that the IMF will have something to do. Now, I don't know whether the G7 will have anything to do with it or whether it will be the G20. I certainly hope that the IMF will have something to do with it.
Well, there you have it, folks.
In New York City, a city that terrorists have targeted at least 16 times since 9/11, when something is out of place and no one knows why, it generates some serious questions. Takes me to what happened today. Look at this. Not just one, actually, but two white flags appeared flying on top of the Brooklyn Bridge. No one knows who put them there. No one knows why. But one thing is for sure, the flags are prompting serious concerns about bridge security.
For centuries, since the beginning of time, some things are beyond legend.
Right before your eyes, to find the one who can save the human race.
To keep us safe.
To protect the city. To save them. To save Earth. To save the world. With a destiny so strong. There's only one woman.
There's only one hope. There is only one.
She has been chosen for the better, for good,
for honor, for hope, for justice, for liberty.
One decision, one leader, one weapon. Only one will rule them